The Prime Minister has used a major pre-budget speech to unveil a $1.5 billion boost to manufacturing to help make Australia a serious global competitor. But he warns it won't be possible without gas-fired power. And when asked how many Aussies would be back in work by Christmas, Scott Morrison wouldn't put a number on it.
It's the pre-budget cash splash that keeps on giving.
Great to be back.
The Prime Minister was all smiles today about the $1.5 billion that will be injected into manufacturing across six key sectors: resources, technology and critical minerals processing, food and beverage, medical products, recycling and clean energy, defence and space. The aim?
With this particular announcement, you're looking at hopefully creating some 80,000 direct jobs, even more indirect jobs. If you were to combine your announcements to date since the start of the year, how many, realistically, how many job-seeking Australians will be in these roles and employed by Christmas time?
Many of the things I've talked about today aren't just about jobs over the next 3 months. They're about jobs over the next 5 years.
Scott Morrison failed to provide a ballpark figure, putting it down to...
In this environment and the uncertainties that exist today, I think making those sorts of punts could be very misleading.
The only thing that Scott Morrison has managed to manufacture in his time in government is announcements.
The opposition leader taking his swipe from a training centre in Sydney's west.
We're in the fastest growing region of the world in human history. What that signals is opportunity.
But the Prime Minister is adamant they are seizing on those opportunities.
It is a massive part of the manufacturing plan.
The manufacturing debate and the energy debate go hand in hand with this announcement. Today, the Prime Minister once again made his case for a gas-led recovery, arguing Australia isn't in the game without it.
I mean, you can't make plastic with wind. You can't make plastic with solar. You make it with gas. You can make it with hydrogen as well.
Stella Todorovic for 10 News First.
And right now on 10 News First Person, a special podcast preview of the federal budget. Two leading economists join finance reporter Gillian Bowen. It is available on 10 Speaks, 10 Play or your favourite podcast platform.